Let's get some more on how to play these markets as we get closer, perhaps, to an answer on the election. We're joined by Michelle Connell, founder of Portia Capital Management. Michelle, did I pronounce that right, or is it Portia?
It's Portia, named after the Merchant of Venice, Tyler.
All right, gotcha. You know, there was something that was very interesting there, and in one of my notes, let's talk about, let's assume that Mr. Biden ascends to the presidency on next January 20th. Let's assume that the Republicans hold on to the Senate, and we know, basically, that the Democrats, with a narrow majority, will hold on to the House. What sectors benefit under a divided government scenario?
I think you're looking at strength pushing into energy because it's been so weak this year. And now we know that regulation of energy is not going to be what we thought it was. And here in Texas, there was a sigh of relief that energy and fracking is still safe. So there's some good names in that particular sector. We're also looking at financials, which have been unloved this year, down about 15% year to date. And looking at the fact there won't be a press for regulation on those. And every time we come out of a presidential election, healthcare usually does well. And I think that will be even more so the case now that we know that we'll probably have less changes in that area as well.
Let me push back a little bit on energy. I see how healthcare could be a beneficiary because a lot of the changes would need legislation behind them. But the executive has a lot of power, she or he, to do things in a regulatory fashion with respect to energy through the EPA and fuel guidelines for cars and so forth. So I'd like you to expand a little bit on why energy could be a beneficiary under Biden when indeed he said 3 weeks ago that he wants to unwind America's dependence on fossil fuels.
I think there would have been more of a fear that that was a possibility if we did indeed have a blue wave. That's not the case now. And so you're going to have a lot of senators, a lot of people in Congress that don't know that their constituents are depending upon those jobs. And when you're looking at the average fracking job making about $60,000 a year, I think that's going to be a tough sell to have, you know, a lot of regulation added into the energy area.
Quick final thought, Michelle, before I let you go. A Biden administration will have what effect on trade and our relations with China? Is it favorable for the Alibabas of the world?
It's definitely favorable because there'll be less pressure on trade. And so we've been fortunate enough to have a weakening dollar. And now that China will have less pressure on them in terms of making concessions, I think you'll start to see more emphasis on the emerging market side of the portfolio. The Alibabas, the Taiwan semiconductors of the world will start to do better than they have in the past. And so I like that part of the world versus some of the other parts of the world versus Europe, for instance.
Oh. Michelle, thank you for spending part of your Friday night with us. Michelle Connell of Portia Capital. Pete, let's trade these ideas that we've just knocked around a little bit.
Sure.
So you kick it off. What's your reaction there?
Yeah, listening to Michelle, I'm on board with her on a couple of those. I look at the financials. I think they're too cheap. I think the balance sheets look great. We all know that there have been issues for a long period of time. That may change into the not too distant future. But they're making so much money in other areas, Tyler, that I just think that this is an area that absolutely has more upside. So we'll see. I like the financials and healthcare. By the way, healthcare, we've seen some great performance of late, and especially this week, obviously, great performance. But I don't think it's over. I think there's plenty of room to the upside still across the board, whether it's a UNH or a Merck or whatever. I think there are different aspects that absolutely can work to the upside. So I would agree with Michelle for sure on those.
Shepard Smith here. Thanks for watching CNBC on YouTube.